Hi, welcome to the world of Naadi Astrology. My name is Dr. N. Srinivasan Shastri. Now today we are going to put one more step forward towards the Naadi Astrology. We have finished up till Mars. Certain unknown things about Mars or significations of Mars we learned. Today let us learn some important things about Mercury. The hidden things, you can so call it as hidden things, or very few people know about these things. Mercury. What is exactly Mercury? Mercury is the significator of intelligence, academic career, languages, good happenings, everything is there. Education, type of education, languages, all these things, even trade or business or law. All these things are signified by the planet Mercury. Okay? So, when Mercury is placed in any sign, any Rasi or sign, okay, that sign's significations or that Rasi's significations will give the native the type of study. Mercury in any sign. Okay. So Mercury in a natal chart, immaterial of its placement, and according to the placement of it, according to the Rasi or sign Mercury is placed, it gives the native the type of education. This is point number one. Point number two. Mercury with other planets in conjunction will tell us how many languages. I told you, Mercury signifies about languages also. So Mercury in conjunction with other planets, how many planets are there in conjunction? So many languages the native is going to learn. A material of male chart or female chart. For example, here, if Moon is there, Mars is there, you can know that he will know three languages. When I say not only in conjunction, seventh house aspect and the trinal sign from the Mars, from the Aries, trinal sign from the Aries is also taken into consideration. This is second point. Third point, when Mercury is having planets in the adjacent houses, for example, Moon here, Rahu here, Moon here, Rahu here. Anyway, in the adjacent houses, if a natal chart is having Mercury in one sign or Rasi, on the other preceding or following sign, if there are other planets, and according to that planets, the native's education or academic career will be coming to one particular fixation, means one particular angle of subject. Okay, if you say medicine, it may be a doctor, he may be a lab assistant, or he may be working about testing drugs, research, anything. So here the adjacent houses planets with the Mercury and the adjacent house planets give us the native's study in particular, immaterial of whether it is a male chart or a female chart. This is another point. Now next, there is one more point. When Mercury is retrograde, these are the techniques to know before looking into a chart. Okay? When Mercury is retrograde, immaterial, in whichever sign he may be placed, in whichever Rasi he may be placed, in whichever chart, male or female chart, the result is the same. Retrograde Mercury tells us that there will be a break in the education which is continuing, and chances of changing the branch of the education is possible for people who are having retrograde Mercury. Okay, this is one point. There is one more thing about Mercury. Mercury retrograde or not, Mercury retrograde or not, if Jupiter, the native Jupiter, okay, if the Jupiter Mercury, how can you know a person's education will be smooth or there will be obstacles in the educational pattern or academic career? We can know through this method. Jupiter, before touching Mercury, if at all there is Mars and Saturn, even Sun is also malefic, but Sun will not disturb the education of Mercury or the significations of Mercury. Mars and Saturn, if they are here, of course, even Rahu, by the time Jupiter moves to Mercury, if he touches Mars or Saturn in between, Rahu or Ketu in between, there will be obstacles in the study point of it. Okay? This is one combination. So totally I have given you. I'll repeat once again. Mercury's placement tells us the nature of study. Mercury having planets in the adjacent houses tells us the particular nature of the study or particular study. From the Jupiter till Mercury, if there are malefics, by the time the native reaches education, there will be obstacles. Second, Mercury with the planets, in conjunction with the planets, tells us about the number of languages a native will learn. Clear? Finally, Mercury retrograde will definitely see that the native jumps into a different branch of study before the completion of the study. This is what we can know about the basics of Mercury. Next, conjunctions, or before conjunctions, there are few more things which we have to learn. Again, any sign or any Rasi, I am not telling you this particular sign or this particular Rasi, for certain professions, for certain study, we need the signs. But right now what I am telling you is without any particular sign. If Mercury follows Jupiter, okay, in a natal chart, whether it is a female chart or a male chart, if Mercury follows Jupiter, in this case, if Mercury follows Jupiter, the native will have study pertaining to either accounts, banking, or spiritual studies, and also law is included here. Okay, if Jupiter is behind Mercury, When Jupiter is behind Mercury, it tells us about the study of law also. Jupiter behind Mercury tells us about law. Mercury having Jupiter tells us about spiritual studies. If I have made a mistake, kindly rectify. I'll repeat once again. When Jupiter has Mercury in the second house, the native study will be pertaining to a banking law about the people. Clear? When Mercury is having Jupiter in the preceding houses, Mercury is having Jupiter in the preceding houses, this will be spiritual studies. This is why I said it is confusing for me, this chart and that chart, whether preceding or following, and that's why I made that mistake. I'll repeat to make it clear. Mercury preceding the Jupiter, the study will be law. Jupiter preceding the Mercury in the next sign or Rasi, it will be about banking and spiritual also. Okay, so this is what Mercury. Now next, there are other planets. If Mercury has, these are the techniques, if Mercury has Rahu and Mars, or even Saturn, if Mercury has in the preceding houses Rahu and Mars, Saturn, the native will study mantras. It may be Vedic mantras, it may be spiritual mantras. He will have an inclination towards the mantras. Don't ask me whether he is going to take up that profession. No. Profession again, it is individual here, Saturn. The study part, what all a man is going to put his fingers into the study, the academic career or the study, what all he learns, that's what. See, we learn so many languages. We don't use it everywhere, we don't use it always. We use it only when we travel to different places with that type of a language. Likewise, I'm telling you the study part. I'm not telling you it is linked with the profession. Okay? Of course, sometimes it is linked. I'll tell you when the point comes. Okay? This is one thing. Second, in case Mars is there, in case Rahu, Mars is there, and instead of Saturn, you got Venus. See, it is very simple. After Mercury, what all the planets are there in those four houses? That immaterial of sign wherever, immaterial of the sign or Rasi where Mercury is placed, those are the planets which give their contribution, whatever they have in store for them, that they will give it to the study. For example, Mars, skills. Rahu, mantras. Mars is also mantras. And Saturn was there, now Venus is here. Now, when you take hold of Venus here, we will take away Rahu. We will get confused now if I put the same planets there. Mercury, Mars and Venus, or Mercury, Saturn, Mars and Venus. In this combination, Mercury, Saturn, Mars and Venus. In this combination, you can know that this native, male or female, will have interest towards the musical instruments. They will study musical instruments, playing musical instrument, writing songs, lyrics, because Mars is nothing but skills. Venus is finance or music or all the finance, painting, music and music instruments, drums. Whatever you call it, this will be the interest the person will be showing, or he will be inclined to learn. Okay, this is about Venus and Venus and Saturn and Mars, this will be that. Okay. Now let's go to one more type of a combination. If Sun is behind Mercury with Venus, it means that the father of the native, Sun is the father. Mercury is lot of businesses, because lot of earning money, Venus is there together. And the second house from Sun is the Dhanasthanam. That means the father will be a rich businessman. Okay, here not only the placements, seventh house aspect, trinal house aspect is also considered. Of course, without the aspect of a malefic, that has to be taken into consideration, because I will give you the main point. Just go on, get stuck to the main point. Kindly, repeatedly I will be telling you the seventh house aspect or the trinal rasis or signs. For example, this is the trinal rasi or sign. For this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this one will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this one. So these are the trinal rasis. For Gemini, it will be Libra and Aquarius. And without any malefic in between them, then only this is possible. So this is about Sun. Next. If at all Jupiter is there behind Mercury and Venus, okay, you can clearly say that the native may have two marriages and good source of income, too many sources of income. Okay, if at all you find Venus and Mercury combination in a male chart, in any sign, in any rasi, in any way, Venus and Mercury combination in a male chart, it clearly tells us that the native will have lot of affairs. Okay. This is one thing. And Mercury retrograde, I told you, it will change. At the same time, from Jupiter in the 10th house, Saturn and Mercury, Mercury and Saturn. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is Jupiter. From Jupiter, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. From Jupiter in the 10th house, if Mercury and Sun are placed, or if Mercury and Sun aspect the 10th house, or if Mercury and Saturn are placed in one of the trinal signs from the 10th house, be sure that the native will be a owner of an educational institution. It may be small time tutorials. It may be a big institution, educational institution. It may be a big engineering college or a medical science college. That's how this one shows. Okay, this is one point. If at all Mercury and Mars are in Gemini. If Mercury and Mars are in Gemini, be sure the native will become a writer, journalist, media personality, something pertaining to media he will learn. Okay? Next thing. If Mercury and Venus, if Mercury and Venus are placed in Pisces or Kanya, clear? If Mercury and Venus are placed in Pisces, Meenam, or in Virgo, Kanya, definitely the native will be having very good yoga, Raj Yoga. Very simple. Uccha Nichi Raj Yoga. Uccha Nichi Banga Raj Yoga. Here also Uccha Nichi Banga Raj Yoga. That's all. Okay? Same. Now I'll put here 3. So that it'll be Gemini. No. 12. And 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. Mercury and Venus. This is 12. Mercury and Venus. So this is a combination. When if you find in any natal chart, Mercury and Venus in Pisces, Meena Rasi, or Mercury and Venus in Virgo, Kanya Rasi, Uccha Neecha Bhanga Raj Yoga, this gentleman will have very good flow of money. Okay? So this is how it's going to go with Mercury and the planets. Next, we have to carry on with, once again, yeah, there is one more combination. There is one more combination for Mercury. So here there is one more combination where Mercury, Venus, Saturn and Mars in the adjacent houses. This combination tells us that the native may become or may study about stock brokerage or deal in share market or money exchange. Okay, stock brokerage, share market, money exchange, commission agent, and also land developers, because Mars is there again at the end. Why I am telling you about the profession? Because Saturn is here. I am not only taking about the Mercury's education, Saturn is involved here. So these are the things it gives us. Okay. So this is about the other combination. And one beautiful combination is there. If at all Mercury and Venus have Saturn retrograde, in the third house, this is one of the wonderful combination. Mercury and Venus having Saturn retrograde in the third house from Mercury, the native will shine very good in life, will earn a lot of money, will see almost all the good things in his life or in the world. Okay, this combination will give him name and fame, popularity, lot of money, and he will shine very well in his professional and domestic life. This one thing I wanted to tell you all. Okay, so we have now finished with certain jumbling of planets. Finally, we are jumping into conjunction. Earlier we had, each time when I touched Sun and other planets, Moon and other planets, we have touched Mercury. But again, as a repetition, or remember the past or reversing it to the back. We want rehearsal, they call it as, or whatever it is. So, Saturn and Mercury, they give the native spiritual studies, law, and sometimes about the medicines, provided other planets, Venus's aspect is there. This is about Mercury and Sun. Now, Mercury and Moon, in any sign, in a natal chart, if you find Mercury and Moon in any sign or Rasi, they will give you foreign languages. He will be interested in learning foreign languages. His study will continue in a foreign country, the native study I am talking. And also, he will be good in studies, fast in studies. Foreign languages, study in a foreign land, and very good study. Clear? Now, Mars. When Mercury and Mars are in conjunction, immaterial of any sign, one thing, in a female chart, it tells us that the husband is very intelligent or a businessman. Second thing, the native, if it is male or a female native, Mars and Mercury together will give breaks or will bring obstacles in the educational or academic career. Okay? And at times, with benefic planets aspect, the same Mars and Mercury will make him a writer, will make him a journalist, will make him a media personality, or will make him a coach. This is what I have been observing. I don't know what else you people will observe. This is only my knowledge which I am sharing it with you. This is about Mars. And about Jupiter. When Mercury is with Jupiter in conjunction, immaterial of the sign and immaterial of male or female charts, it gives the native education pertaining to spiritual sciences, education pertaining to astrology, education pertaining to banking industry, all these set of things will come. Okay? Next, Venus. If Mercury and Venus are together in any sign or Rasi, it will give him or it will make the native a lover of fine arts. He will learn too many languages. And if it is a male chart, too many affairs. And too many sources of income. This is what Mercury and Venus gives the native. Okay? If Sun is aspecting, or Sun is in the trinal signs too, Mercury and Venus, medicine, chemicals will come into academic career. Okay, now about Saturn. When Mercury is in conjunction with Saturn, definitely there will be hurdles in the professional academic career. And the natives, education and the profession will be the same. He may become a contractor, he may become a developer. Developer of a land, a developer plot, or whatever it is. Okay, next, Rahu. When Mercury and Rahu are in conjunction, again, struggles in academic career, but it will give the native some interest in research, or if benefic planets aspect is there, aviation, study of aviation, photography, all this, detective part of the work or detective study, whatever it is, these are the things which comes for Rahu. Okay, and if Mercury is with Kethu, the final one, 100% it will be spiritual sciences, Vedic culture, Vedic text or Vedic studies, chemicals, electrifications. This is the combinations. This I have already told you all, but again I wanted to repeat it. Fine. Now finally, good happenings. I also told you that Mercury tells us about good happenings. Whenever Saturn touches or aspects Mercury in the third house sight, when it is in the 11th house from Mercury, at that time there will be a function, there will be a celebration in the house. That I am going to show it to you now. We will place Mercury in one particular Rasi or sign. I don't know what sign it is, I don't know what Rasi it is, some sign, some Rasi. Mercury here. Okay? Mercury. If at all Saturn is there in the second house from Mercury, it takes nearly 50 and odd years to have or to go to the 11th house of Mercury, and only in the second round is going to do that after 30 years, because the first 30 years whatever he does for the native. It will not be a ceremony. Ceremony means Mercury is nothing but relatives, Mercury is nothing but neighbors, Mercury is nothing but get together. That get together, it does not happen for an individual, it happens for the whole family. So what I mean to say is, Mercury, when it has Saturn in the second house, there will be a ceremony. I'll tell you the age and how you have to calculate the age. This is 30 years. Saturn takes 30 years for one complete round. Don't ask me about the retrogradeness. That particular period, 6 months here and there, that will go. No. You follow this and you will get the right answer. You forget about the retrogradeness. Okay? Retrogradeness you see only when you are pointing out to one particular incident, when you see a chart. But about the happenings, blindly you can rush through. Okay? Saturn takes till here. This is the beginning of Saturn. Saturn is in the second house from Mercury. So from 30 years it will take here. And 2.5, 2.5, 35. 2.5, 2.5, 40. 2.5, 2.5, 45. 2.5, 2.5, 50. And this is 5, 55. When Saturn comes to the 11th house, he will have the third house aspect of Mercury. Follow? I'll repeat. How many houses are there till the 11th house from Mercury? That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 twos are 20. 10 halves are 5. Okay? 2.5 years in one Rasi. So this is 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 twos are 20. And 10 twos are 20. This is half. No, where I was wrong. Yeah, after 30 it is 10 twos are 20 plus 5, 25. So from 30 plus 30. That is at the age of 55. At the age of 55. I'll repeat. I don't think I have just convinced it in the right way. Till here it is 30 years is over. First round is over, because first round of Saturn, whatever it does, it'll be only to the need. And the function is something pertaining to the family. Now I am talking about the happenings, the function or the celebration or whatever it is inside the family, good things. That when it will happen, if at all Saturn is there in the second house from Mercury, first 30 years is for the native, we don't bother. Next, whenever Saturn has the third house sign, then only will give the happenings, because third house exactly Mercury is sitting. Whenever he aspects Mercury, third house sign, he will give you the functions and celebrations. Even 7th house, even 10th house, but major incidents, major happenings will happen in this part. So the first one, 30 years till the placement of Saturn, over. Then 5 years, 35, 540, 545, 550, 555. Exactly at the age of 55 of the native, the Saturn aspects Mercury. So when Saturn is in the second house from Mercury, at the age of 55, the native will have celebrations in the house. Note it down. Clear? Now, Saturn in the third house. Okay? Saturn in the third house. We have to come till here. We have to come till here. How many years it will take? When it is in the second house, it is 55. Second house Saturn, the function it at the age of 55 years of the native. Now Saturn is in the third house. Third house from Mercury. Saturn takes 30 years for one round, it comes here. Now how many houses are pending? 30, the round is over. Plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 house. 9 into 2 equals 18, 9 half, that is 4 and half, 22 or 23. This is 22. At the age of 52 and 53. Well, let's take 53. When Saturn is in the third house from Mercury, good things will happen. At what age of the native? 30 years behind Saturn. 5, 35, 5, 40, 5, 45, 5, 50. And 2 and a half or 3. 53. At the age of 53, when Saturn is placed in the third house from Mercury, at the age of 53, the native will have celebrations at home. You can tally it. Now I am just giving it in front of you. But after that, you are going to see how far it is going to be true. And I bet it will be perfect. Saturn in the fourth house. I will change here also. Third house is the same, 11th house is the same. It has to aspect the third house, it has to give the third house aspects to Mercury for functions or ceremonies to begin. So, from Mercury, Saturn is in the fourth house. From Mercury, Saturn in the fourth house. 30, till 30, it will be here. Then, these two houses, 35, 40, 45, 50. Exactly at the age of 50, when he is in the fourth house, I'll tell you. Saturn is here. So 1, 2, 35, 1, 2, 40, 1, 2, 45, 1, 2, or even here. 30, 35, 40, 45. How this? One second. So somewhere something is wrong. The third house is over. 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Yeah, this is right. Whatever, I am not getting it here. Saturn. Till here it has to come. Yeah. Till here it has to come. 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Yeah. When Saturn is in 4th house, 50 years. When Saturn is in 5th house, again it will be 2 less, 48. When Saturn is in the 6th house, it will be 46. When Saturn is in the 7th house, it will be 44. When Saturn is in the 8th house, it will be 42. When Saturn is in the 9th house, it will be 40. Like that, you can go up till 12 houses. I will take one of the examples here. 9. Okay. From Mercury, Saturn is in the 9. Okay. 30, 35. 37. Finished. 9th house. 30. 35. 40. Yeah. 40. I hope you understood. This is how it is got about the happenings of the incidents, good happenings. I think I will end my session about Mercury here. If at all anything I remember, if at all anything I have to do for you, I'll definitely bring it when I am doing the transiting Jupiter. This is a part of transiting Saturn, natal transiting Saturn. This is only because we are touching Mercury, and Mercury is nothing but get together, family members, neighbors, and that's why I am giving you this happenings. Otherwise, I would have touched only the study part. Mercury gives us other additional things also, just like Mars gave us. So I had to give you this particular portion today. Okay, na? So till I meet you next time, I think I'll wait. Bye.